Hey guys, so I got some new betta fish, so I want to introduce them to you. They are both males and from Petco. I didn't film getting them because I was with a friend who actually picked one of them out for me, and she also named them both, so I put them in this 5-gallon and divided it again. The female platy that was in here before, I moved back to the 20-gallon because the male platy in there passed away, so it was safe to move her back in there, and she never ended up having fry, but she does always look pregnant, which is weird, but anyway. So I was planning on getting a new betta. Of course, I ended up getting two because it's hard to just take home one betta. So I'll start with the guy on the right. This is a male, not quite fully grown, crown tail. Here's the lid that was on his cup. So just a basic crown tail male. And he has white scales with red fins. His pectoral fins are also red. So anyway, the name that was chosen for him is Ares. So they are Greek names. This is Ares. And next to Ares here on the left side is a Half Moon King male betta. This is the one I picked out. I was really attracted to him because he has like a green sheen over him. He like sometimes looks blue and sometimes looks green. I guess you could call that turquoise, but right now under this lighting he looks pretty blue, but if he gets more under the light he'll appear green. Anyway, I just thought that was really pretty, and king bettas always attracted me with their just enormous size. It was really awesome. Oh, look, he's flaring. He does have some red in his fins. Anyway, he's a feisty guy, really big. I'm actually thinking about giving him this whole tank and setting up a different one for this guy because this just doesn't seem to be enough space for him. And if you can see, he does have quite a large tumor at the base of his body. His pectoral fins are quite pretty as well, as you can see. Anyway, hopefully that tumor won't be life-threatening. I wouldn't have gotten him if he wasn't so pretty. But yeah, he also has some black on his head, and his eyes are covered in some like green scales, but that doesn't seem to affect his eyesight for some reason. He can clearly see himself and food. So anyway, hopefully this guy stays healthy regardless of that tumor on his back. Here's his lid. So yeah, I'm definitely going to most likely move this guy to his own tank so I can remove this divider and give him the whole 5 gallons, because a 2.5 is just a bit too small for a king betta, in my opinion. Oh, and before I forget, this guy's name is Poseidon, which I think suited him pretty well, and Ares, the other one, suited him fairly well as well. So those are my new betta fish. I hope you like them and their names. I also hope you're happy to see bettas on the channel again, because I sure am happy to have bettas back again. It's kind of hard to live without them. So yeah, thanks again for watching. Bye!